The topic the next comes next is the Fazan's rule and the polarizing power and the polarizability. What does it mean and how Fazan's rule guide you that how much covalent character is inserted in an ionic compound is very is discussed in this topic. Okay, so the type of bonds formed between the two oppositely charged ions A plus and B minus depends upon the charge of the ions and the size of the ions that we have already discussed, because the Coulombic force that holds the ions very close is proportional to the charge of the ions and the mutual distance or the nucleus to nucleus distance between the ions. The cation attracts the electron cloud of the anions towards itself at the same time repels the nucleus. This results in the distortion of the negatively charged ionic clouds, and the negative and the negative ion is at that condition polarized. Similarly, the negative ions can also polarize the positive ion, but here you have to keep in mind the size of the ions. Anions are generally larger than the positive ions. Since anions are larger in size than cations, therefore their electron clouds are less tightly held. As a result, the distortion effect of the larger ions on the small ions will be less pronounced. That means the polarizing power. So in this section, I just discussed about that a cation is generally smaller in size and its charge is distributed in a very small volume region. So it can polarize a negatively charged ions, which is generally diffuse in the charge. So it can easily polarize its electron clouds, but at the same time anion can also polarize the cations, but as we know cations are generally compact in size and smaller, its charge is distributed in a smaller region, so the magnitude of this polarization is very less, so we generally not consider these things. So generally cations polarize an anion easily. Okay, and the polarizing power of a cation depends upon the charge of the cations and the volume, or you can say the size of the cation, and it is called as polarizing power. So polarizing power is the ratio of charge by volume ratio. The power of an ion to distort the electron cloud of the other ions is called its polarizing power. That is, we can generally use this term for cations, and the tendency of the ions to get distorted is known as polarizability. So this term is generally applicable to anions. So this is the situation. Suppose a large cation and a small, comparatively small size of anion comes come into the lattice and forms the ionic crystal, and when there is no polarization power takes place in this condition. But if the cation has small in size and the anion is large in size, then we know that cation can easily polarize the electron cloud of the anion. So this type of condition will happens, and we tell this condition as polarized condition, or polarization occurs. Okay, so now we discuss about the Fazan's rule and how Fazan's rules helps in calculating or describing the covalent character that develops in an ionic bond. Okay, so first one, Fazan's rule basically depends upon three postulates, and we successively discuss about these three postulates. First one is the size of the ion. Smaller the size of the cation and larger the size of the anion, that is this type of situation, greater is the covalent character of the ionic bond. Okay, and next is the charge of the cation. Greater the charge of the cation, greater is the covalent character of the ionic bond. You know that polarizing power depends on the charge of the cation and divided by the volume of the cation. So its charge increases, then its polarizing power also increases. The third point is the electronic configuration for cations with the same charge and size. The ions with the n-1 d n and NS0 configuration, which is found in transition metal elements, have greater covalent character than the cations with the NS2 NP6 configuration, which is commonly found in alkali and alkaline earth metal. What does it mean for elements, or particularly I can say transition elements, which have d orbital in their configuration? And we know that d orbital has very less screening power. That means it can screen its nuclear charge for the outermost electron. So the effective nuclear charge that fills is higher for a elements containing d orbital or f orbital. So it will impart more polarizing power to a anion in comparison to the same size and same charge cation that is generally found in the alkali and alkaline earth type metal. So we'll discuss these three points successively. First one is the rule one. The first rule speaks that the polarizing power of the cation, the smaller the positive ion, the charge is concentrated over a very small region. This makes the positive ion highly polarizing, And polarizing power is directly proportional to the charge density, that means charge by radius. The polarizing power of the cation decreases with increase in the size of the cations. Definitely, if you increase the size as it is appear in the denominator of this expression, so its polarizing power also decreases. Taking the example of group 2 metal chloride, the melting point generally decreases down the group in this way. So beryllium, all are two plus two conditions. So beryllium chloride is have less melting point than magnesium chloride, has less melting point than calcium chloride, than strontium chloride, than barium chloride. And we know that as we decrease down the, as we going down the group, the size of the cation increases. That means its polarizing power decreases, and ultimately in beryllium chloride it doesn't have almost no covalent character, whereas beryllium chloride has a huge amount of covalent character. That means it is partially covalent, or it contains a huge amount of covalent character, and beryllium chloride doesn't have any covalent character. So its melting point, directly we know that ionic compound has higher melting point, so beryllium chloride has higher melting point than covalently covalent character beryllium chloride. So which indicates that beryllium chloride is more covalent character than barium chloride, which is practically not polarizing at all. That means barium chloride is totally ionic, or beryllium than beryllium chloride. And beryllium chloride is contains a huge amount of covalent character. That's why its melting point is less. And the explanation of the rule 2, the second rule speaks about the polarizability of the anion. The polarizability of the anion increases with increase in the size of the anion. This is because the electron cloud of the large anion is less tightly held by the nucleus. Definitely, as we as the size of the anion increases, then its electron cloud is distributed in the very huge region and definitely diffuses more. Okay, consequently it can be easily polarized by a cation, and this can be illustrated by taking the example of various halides of potassium. We have taken the same cation potassium and with the different anions, so fluoride, chloride, bromide, iodide. So if you if we go from potassium fluoride to potassium chloride to potassium bromide to potassium iodide, we generally observe that potassium fluoride has high melting point than potassium iodide, because as we go from fluoride to chloride, so as the size of the anion increases from fluoride to chloride to bromide to iodide, that means its polarizability of the iodide is highest and fluoride has lowest. So Ki contains a huge amount of covalent character, and its melting point definitely decreases in comparison to Kf. The covalent character increases, which reduces the melting point. Okay, and now the third point, which is the explanation of rule 3. Cations with the 18 electron shell configuration are, we sometimes it is known as pseudo noble gas configuration. Generally, noble gas configuration is regarded as in the outermost orbital, the element should have 8 electrons. But in case of pseudo noble gas, because of these intervening d orbitals containing 10 electrons, it possesses 18 electrons. So cations with the 18 electron shell configuration causes greater polarizing power or polarization than such cations with 18 electron shell configuration with the same size and charge. That means if you take two cations having the same size and same charge, then the cations belonging to this type of transition metal elements having 18 electron configuration have more polarizing power than a cation. Now, in case of 18 electron ion, that is for example copper ion, there are n-1 d10 electrons apart from the ns and np electrons. The d electrons, we know that cannot shield the nuclear charge effectively. As a result, the cations will exert a higher nuclear charge on the anions in comparison to a cations having the 18 electron shell configuration. So we have taken both the example of copper plus 1 and sodium plus 1. Both have almost the same size, and the sodium has the electronic configuration 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, and while the copper plus 1 has the 18 electron type configuration. So on the outermost is shown here, so 3s2, 3p6 and 3d10, and you know that d orbitals have very less screening power, so the effective nuclear charge that is exerted by the copper plus 1 is higher than sodium plus. Since copper plus ions polarizes the anion to a greater extent than sodium plus ion, the copper halide, as for example copper chloride, is slightly covalent in character than sodium chloride. Thus copper chloride is insoluble in water because it is a covalent type molecules, and low melting point, and because and then high. So copper chloride is insoluble in water and having a very low melting point in comparison to sodium chloride. Similarly, we can take the example of mercuric chloride is a covalent compound than calcium chloride. Both have the same +2 charge and almost similar size in size. But we know that the electronic configuration of mercury 2 plus and calcium 2 plus are as follows. Mercury 2 plus xenon 4a14 5d10, and for calcium 2 plus 1s2 2s2 2p6 3s2 3p6. So because of the presence of the f orbital and the d orbital, we know that the effective nuclear charge that is felt by the anion when mercury is present is comparison to higher. That means mercury exerted high polarizing power than calcium. With the pseudo noble gas configuration with mercury 2 plus has more polarizing power, and the consequently HgCl2 is more covalent than those of calcium chloride. And calcium chloride is a ionic compound, and mercuric chloride is a covalent type compound.